Student friends,
up to yesterday's lecture, we have covered three topics from paper number 16. And today, we are going to start with topic number 4. And the topic number 4 is microwave and radar communication. Dear students, you are well aware with the microwave. You may ask the question, how? Answer for that is, in semester 5th, when you have studied the propagation of the radio waves, when we have studied the sky wave propagation, we studied that. If the transmitting antenna, transmitter has got a high power, it radiates the high frequency, then the radiations emitted by the transmitting antenna from the transmitter penetrates the ionospheric layer. After penetrating the ionospheric layer, it reaches to the space. Those waves, those radiations, we can call it as the microwaves. And there we have introduced the microwave. Thus we can say microwave has high frequency, short wavelength, high power radiations. Means short wavelength, high frequency, high power radiations which can cover a long distance for the communication and even for the other applications. Those waves we can call it as the microwaves. Student friends, you are well aware that microwave ovens are well familiar in the kitchen room. These microwaves are used for generating the heat also. So these details of these waves we are going to study in this particular topic. Obviously, we also know that microwaves are used for the satellite communication. We have studied this concept in the topic this semester, that is in the satellite communication. Dear students, these microwaves are also used for the radar communication. At the beginning, we are going to study the meaning of microwave, their applications, basics associated with the microwaves, some of the advantages and disadvantages associated with them. Microwave devices, transmission lines, waveguides, resonators, some microwave tubes, microwave semiconducting devices. All those are the aspects related with the microwaves. By using these waves, how radar works, how radar communication takes place. Radar means radio active detection and ranging. Sometimes it is also called radio amplification, detection and ranging. It is a device that is used in communication to detect the target and also to determine the range of that particular target. Detecting the target and determining the range of the target is done in the radar communication by using again the microwave radiations. That's fine. We are going to study topic number 4 combinedly as a microwave and radar communication. We are going to proceed to learn this particular topic with our specific plan. And that's what we can call it as, it is a lecture plan. So the lecture plan associated with the topic number 4, that is a microwave and radar communication. We are going to begin with basics of microwave, because one has to know the knowledge of the microwave so that the microwave devices are going to be gets operated in the field of communication. So that's why you are going to study the basics of microwaves, advantages and disadvantages of the microwave, applications of the microwave, then transmission lines, means how microwave radiations are carried away from one place to the another place in the device. Then we are going to study the waveguide, which is again a type of transmission line. Then we are going to study the cavity resonators. After that, we are going to study some of the microwave semiconductor devices, some high power microwave tubes we are going to study as an amplifiers, that is a klystron tube is a part of our syllabus. But apart from that, there is a magnetron tube, there is a traveling wave tube amplifiers, rest of the tubes are also available, but out of three we are going to study only the klystron tube. This forms the aspect of the microwaves. After knowing the details associated with the microwaves, after familiarizing us to the microwaves, we are going to begin with the radar. In the radar, we are going to study its principle, means how range is detected, how the range of the target is calculated and displayed. What is the principle behind that? That we are going to study. After that, we are going to study types of radar. In that, we are going to study details associated with the pulsed radar. This is the plan of our lectures, so as to complete the microwave and radar communication as topic number 4. Just we are going to continue or introduce with the basics of microwave communication, or basics of microwaves, we can call it. Dear students, microwaves, or the microwave signal, is the signal having the high frequency within the frequency range of 1 GHz to 30 GHz. Please do remember basics of microwaves, because many objective type questions are going to be arising on these basics. So that's why you can say microwave signals have the high frequency within the range of 1 GHz to 30 GHz. For the special cases, 300 GHz frequency is also to be treated as the microwave signal. As we already studied that, microwave has a short wavelength. Typically, it is 30 centimeter. The microwave, if those are used for the communication, it is going to solve the many problems in the frequency spectrum which are used for the communication purpose. Especially, overcrowding of the radio spectrum, the radio frequency spectrum. Radio frequency spectrum means what? It is a frequency band of different spectra. The spectrum contains the cosmic rays, X-rays, gamma rays, ultrasonic radiations, X-rays, then low frequency, high frequency, medium range frequency, ultra high frequency, very high frequency, visible frequency range, IR frequency range, all these frequency forms a kind of a frequency spectra which for which we are well familiar. Within this particular frequency range, the frequencies which are used for the communication purpose is beginning from very low frequency, mid frequency, high frequency, very high frequency, and ultra high frequency region. These frequency regions, out of these frequency regions, almost all frequency bands are necessarily used for the purpose of communication. We studied low frequency are used for surface wave communication or ground wave communication. Increase in frequency is used for space wave communication, tropospheric waves communication. If you increase frequency further in megahertz range, they can be used for even sky wave communication. In gigahertz, they are used for the satellite communication, and even those are used for the microwave communication. So all these frequencies are going to lie within the radio frequency spectra. And if these microwave radiations are used for the communication purpose, they are going to solve overcrowding of the radio spectrum. Means it is going to provide the maximum bandwidth for the communicating signal. This will solve the channel width problem. So that's why the microwave plays a very vital role in the high frequency communication. So that's why we can say the microwave communication solved many problems of the overcrowding radio spectrum. But to work with them, one should know the knowledge of microwave and microwave equipment. Why we are going to study this particular topic? The reason behind that is, we should get the knowledge of microwave and we should get the knowledge of microwave equipment. If you know basic of this, then one can use these devices for the purpose of microwave communication, which is going to solve many problems or overcrowding the radio frequency spectra. Dear students, every electronic signal in communication has a finite bandwidth. To undergo the communication aspect, bandwidth plays a very vital role. Depending upon bandwidth only, the transmitting and receiving equipments are going to be gets designed. Transmitter uses the amplifier of the various stages. Receiver uses the amplifiers of the various stages. They have certain bandwidth, and to design those amplifier, it is going to depends upon bandwidth of communicating signal. So that's how we can say every electronic signal in a communication has a finite bandwidth. Maybe it is analog communication or maybe it is a digital communication. When carrier is modulated by an information, it occupies a space in the form of sideband in a radio frequency spectrum. We are also well aware that any message, any information is transmitted from transmitter towards the receiver within an allotted bandwidth after being that signal is modulated with the carrier wave. Either digitally or by using concept of analog modulation. Once the modulation has been done, it occupies the space in the form of a sideband in the radio frequency spectrum. We studied it. We studied amplitude modulation, and we studied that it has a upper sideband and lower sideband. Even when we have studied a frequency modulation in the last semester, it has a plenty, infinity number of side bands. So that's why we can say when any information is modulated with the carrier wave, it occupies the certain space in the form of a sideband in the radio frequency spectrum. This is called as a channel. This is called as a channel. When it occupies certain bandwidth in a RF spectrum, that forms the channel through which the signal is going to be traveling. Due to increasing need of radio communication, nowadays, in the form of TV, there are many types of communications which are used. That's why the word here used is increasing need of radio communication. What are the communication aspects which are used nowadays? Television communication is there. Radio communication means audio only. Then telephone communication, cable television is there. Internet communication is there. Mobile communication is there. Fax is there. All these communication occupies certain bandwidth, forms a certain channel within the radio frequency spectrum. Means within that particular radio frequency spectrum only, almost all these types of the communications are taking place. And that is the reason why crowding of the signal that takes place within that particular spectrum. That's why we mentioned the statement that the micro communication solves many problems of overcrowding the radio frequency spectrum. How crowding that takes place? Because nowadays different types of communication are increasing day by day. All that is taking place within the same radio frequency spectrum. And that's why radio frequency spectrum becomes crowded and crowded. This crowdedness is going to be reduced if we use microwave range for the purpose of communication. Different electronic technology, mobile, fax occupies a different bandwidth in the channel with higher frequency in a radio frequency spectrum. Different electronic technology like DSB, which I already studied, that is a double sideband, SSB, single sideband, PSK, phase shift keying, ASK, amplitude shift keying, FSK, frequency shift keying, multiplexing, all these techniques are used. For what? For communication purpose, to reduce the bandwidth, to reduce the overcrowded situation in the radio frequency spectrum. In spite of using all these techniques, microwaves is that particular waves which can reduce the overcrowded situation in the radio frequency spectrum. That is the major advantages of microwave. In spite of all these things, but in the microwave region, high frequency provides large bandwidth. In the microwave frequency region, in radio frequency range, it provides a large bandwidth. It not only gives more space for individual station, but also bandwidth. It not only gives space for individual station in a microwave range, but it also provides the bandwidth for information signal. Wide bandwidth makes the use of different multiplexing techniques which can be handled in the microwave region. See how the microwaves are advantageous, especially to reduce the overcrowdedness and provides more space in a high frequency range communicating signal. Not only that, the binary communication, that is a digital communication, which needs again more bandwidth, this can be easily accommodated for new communication services. Now, communication techniques are developed for microwave with which the solution to growing need of spectrum. So this entire aspect gives you the main advantage of microwave to reduce the problems of overcrowding in the radio frequency spectrum. Friends, we are well aware, or we all of us are experiencing the disadvantages of crowded region of the people. When we enter into the crowded region of the persons, we feel uneasy, we feel uncomfortable. So that's why we are in a way to search the space within that crowdedness, so that it becomes easy for us, for the respiration and all other things. Same is the situation for the community. Channel is fixed, width is fixed. Within that only, if number of aspect of communications are taking place, like TV, radio, telephone, cable, internet, mobile, all the others will be occupied within the same spectrum, within an allotted bandwidth, so as to give a channelization for all these type of the communicating signal, including even digital communication by using the different communication techniques. The microwave is very good solution which is going to solve the growing need of the radio frequency spectrum. So that is what we can call it as the basics of microwave. Why we are going to study microwave? Why these are used for the communication in a high frequency range? In one sentence, again I can say, it is going to solve the many problems of overcrowding the radio frequency spectrum and accommodate almost all the communicating signals in a high frequency range through the microwave frequency band, which is going to lie in between, say, 1 GHz to 30 GHz. So that's what you have to remember as a basics of the microwave type of communication. Let me proceed with studying the disadvantages, especially associated with the microwave. Almost all advantages we have covered in the basics of microwave. That is, it reduces the overcrowdedness of radio frequency spectrum, provides the frequency bandwidth, provides the channel width for the growing need of different kinds of communicating signals in that particular frequency range. That is the major advantages of the microwave. Now we are going to study some of the disadvantages. The first one is that as frequency is high, it is difficult to analyze the electronic circuit. Means as the frequency of microwave range is very, very high, 1 GHz to 30 GHz. That's why it becomes very difficult to analyze it by using electronic circuit. To perform the analysis of high frequency microwave radiation becomes a difficult. Next one is, for microwave, electric and magnetic measurements makes power measurements to be used. As a microwave includes the electromagnetic radiations, it contains the electric field as well as the magnetic field, which was studied again in semester 5th in the radio propagation. Almost all communicating radiations are electromagnetic radiations that contains the electric field as well as the magnetic field. Analogous to that, microwave is also communicating signal in a high frequency range. So that's why it also contains the electric and magnetic field. The measurement of electric and magnetic measurement makes use of high power measuring devices are required. So that is another disadvantage. Next one is, the conventional components becomes more difficult to implement. Means when we are constructing our circuitries, electronic circuitry, we are using the conventional component, but these conventional components are not suitable to be used in the microwave frequency range. For example, a resistor at low frequency act as a pure resistor, but in microwave range it act as a LCR circuit. This is an example how it is not suitable in microwave range. Our usual resistor is going to act as a resistor in a low frequency range, but when same resistor is used in high frequency range, it is not going to act as a resistor, but it is going to act as a LCR circuit. If simple resistor we have connected, if it starts going to act as a LCR circuit, there may be a resonance possible and unwanted things are going to happen within the micro radiations. So that's why the conventional component, our means our resistor, capacitor, inductor with large size devices are not possible to be used in microwave frequency range. Next means to create a resonance circuit, use of inductor, capacitor must be smaller and smaller. Size of inductance, capacitor must be as small as it is possible. The lumped parameters are not used. Instead of that, distributed parameters are used. Distributed means small size parameters. Next one is conventional semiconductor device will not work at this frequency. Conventional semiconducting devices, that is our PN junction diode, transistor, FET, our usual semiconductor device are not able to work in this particular frequency range. Why? Due to inherent capacitor. When these devices are fabricated, within the internally fabrication, interjunction capacitors are formulated. Or inductor produces lack of gain. This reduces the gain in high frequency. Then again another problem is a transient time is also a problem. This is solved by new microwave devices like klystron tube, magnetron tube and also traveling wave tube amplifier. Instead of using our conventional semiconductor devices, BZT, FET, instead of using them, one can use the klystron tubes, magnetron tubes and traveling wave tubes as amplifying devices. Or a special microwave semiconducting devices are also capable to be used in that particular frequency range. We are going to study details afterwards. Next disadvantage is microwave signal travels straight. Communication distance is limited. Thus, height of antenna be more. Short wavelength signals easily reflected or diverted. This is another disadvantage which is associated with the microwave. So these are the disadvantages. Advantage we have studied in the basics of microwaves. In the last slide, previous slide, we can call it as. Let us proceed to study the applications of microwaves. What are the areas, what are the fields where the microwaves are used? Students, please remember that microwaves are used for the telephone communication, including mobile communication, obviously. These are used for the radar communication. Microwaves are also used for the television communication. Microwaves are used for cable television network. Microwaves are used for space communication, satellite communication and deep space probe for the space study. Also microwaves are used to study stars, planets as a microwave telescope. Micro telescopes are used to perform the study of stars and planets in a space. Especially in Ooty, micro telescope, horizontal micro telescope they are using. And at Pune in Narayangaon, there are 21 micro dish antennas are going to be gets located. Which works on the microwave radiation communicating signal, and those are used to perform the study of stars and planets in a space. Microwaves are also used as a microwave heating in a microwave oven, in a kitchen, and in industry. Means microwaves are used as a microwave heating, as a microwave oven, and in kitchen, and as well as in industry. That means in general, wherever microwave ovens are there, in that microwave radiations are used to generate the heat. Maybe those are used in kitchen, or maybe those are going to use in any type of industry. So these are the applications of the microwave. Friends, in today's lecture, we studied the meaning of microwaves, its advantage, that is basics of microwaves, some disadvantages, and also the applications of the microwaves. This is the beginning of this particular topic. As per plan, we have covered three aspects of the microwaves. The rest we'll see it in the next period.